working again? Let me go park somewhere. Fuck, I gotta use the restroom too. Hold on. I'm not gonna start answering again until I know my internet is stable. This is fucking retarded. Like, said this shit like 3 times. Oh shit, what is that? Oh fuck, that's a handicap parking spot. Fuck. Get a donut? Dude, I've eaten so much chocolate shit today, I can't eat anymore. Oof. Oh, it's cold outside, boys. Wish me luck. What should I leave you guys with? Fuck, all these songs are so old. I'm like sick of every song I have on this. Why don't you have internet at home? I don't know, ask Cox. Oh, here you go. That's a good one. I'll be right back. What's up? Ugh, I gotta get some water, sorry. What did the girl in red flannel get? Oh, I'm not sure. She had some big ol' boobers, so. Yo, by the way, you're not even really that short. I don't know why people fuck on you for it. There's a guy on the internet called Mr. Medicar, and he went like on a huge binge at some point calling me short. So his entire fan base, which is a lot of gamer gators, all use that, like those kinds of jokes against me as an insult. Alright, I'm gonna try to drive again. Good luck. Fuck, it's not worth it. Ugh. Yeah, I'm 5'8". What am I scared of? Oh, so in terms of, like, scary events... Oh. Wait, can we not get out over here? Whatever. I'm not, like, a scared person. The scaredest I think I've ever been... Like, I mean, I would be scared if I was falling out of an airplane or something, right? I'm not, like, super God. If I was standing on the edge of the building, I would probably be scared of like, falling off. If that makes sense. But I don't have, like, a paranoia of heights. Or a paranoia of spiders or something like that. I think the most scared I've ever been recently was probably that thing I said that happened last night. Or two nights ago at Halloween. Was it last night when I was with Aaron? I was scary as fuck. I'm really scared of dying. I'm incredibly scared of dying. I would endure a great deal of suffering to avoid dying. I know that a lot of people talk about how at the end, like if I'm in a lot of pain, just kill me. I hope they kill me so they don't have to suffer. I would be like at the very last, like with the fucking chemo bullshit and everything. Oh, I don't know, dude. Death is really, really scary to me. Mr. Medicare openly left Gamergate 3 years ago when the ethics cooks didn't want to be his personal cyber army and instead actually talked to people they don't agree with. Nice. Would you offer Nathan for your own life? No, I would never do anything to jeopardize the life of my kid. Have you ever been in real pain, though? Probably not. All the fights that I got in with my exes, you never felt any of the pain until after the fight because you were so hyped up when it was happening. The worst I've ever heard in my entire life, been hurt in my entire life, was probably the getting stung by jellyfish. That was easily the most, like, oh my God, that was excruciatingly painful. What happened two nights ago? I thought I'd describe this on stream. So, I'm usually pretty alert to my surroundings as part of my advanced concealed carry weapons permit training. But just in general, I kind of like to be aware of what's going on. It's really important to me. I'm the kind of driver who's like always checking his rearview mirrors and shit just because I like to know what's going on around me. When we were driving last night, we started... There, down the road from us. So you see like where that stoplight is? The green stoplight up there? Hold on. I don't know if you can really tell. This camera's like really fucky. So, would you say is that like 200 yards ahead of me? I feel like I know distance is better in PUBG than in real life. Hold on one second. 200 yards would be like 2 football fields, right? I don't know why I said that. I don't really know how long a football field is. It's not like I play a lot of football. Well, but I should know distances from cross country, right? I don't know. Regardless, there were two cars that were stopped before an intersection. And the two cars were parked horizontally. Kind of like how you would block off a bridge in PUBG. Where, the cars were like parked like so that I can't really demonstrate it because I'll get pulled over if there's a cop, but where you're horizontal in the road. So I noticed it, like, pretty far ahead. And as soon as I noticed it, I started to slow down. Because it was very, very, very weird. I've never seen that in my entire life. And so I'm kind of like, we're crawling towards these people. And I get like really paranoid. So I tell Aaron to get my gun out of the back seat just because I was like, it was like really fucking sketch. And as soon as I tell her that, I check my rearview mirror and I see two cars that both turned into the road behind me that started pulling up. And I fucking gunned it, dude. Holy shit. There was a parking lot to my right. I got out of there faster than I've ever got anything in my whole life. My heart rate went from, like, whatever to, like, 700 BPM plus, like, in 2 seconds. It was, like, my lower back started to hurt. I was insanely stressed. Holy shit. That was easily the scariest I've ever been, like, I think in recent memory. Holy fuck, that was some scary-ass shit. I thought I was about to get fucked. Oh, my God. It was probably nothing, right? I imagine it was probably nothing. But, like, oh my God, that was so fucking weird. What were they doing? I have no idea. It was just weird. I've never seen people block off a road like that. And then when I saw the two people, like, pulling up behind me in either lane, going the same speed, it was, like, really, really... I had to leave. How was Aaron feeling? I don't know. I don't know if she cared that much. I'm not sure. But it made me really, really, really nervous. I got very, very, very nervous. I get that lower back adrenaline pain too. Oh yeah? I don't think I've ever actually felt that before. It was really strange. I just remember getting like really, really worried and then like my lower back started to like feel like, it was like a really weird like sharp pain. I got really scared, holy shit. Was I in the ghetto? Yes, I was in North Omaha, which is where my uncle lives. And a girl had literally been shot like 4 hours earlier in the parking lot of the fucking CVS. Yeah, I was hardcore paranoid. Holy shit. Were they black? I don't know. I didn't pull up close enough to find out. Do you ever go to any parties in college or high school? In high school I did a bit, but in college I just didn't have the time to. In high school I tried to do as much as I could because the home life got really depressing. This is where our memes to feel story can come in. A lot of the times the power was cut off at the main house that I lived. The power and sometimes the utilities. So if I would end up waiting at school, we'd get out at 2:15 or 3:30 if there was band. I'd wait until like 6 o'clock for my dad to pick me up. He would drop me off at home and then he would go back to the office or whatever. And then I would just be stuck at the house with no heat in the fucking dark with fuck all to do except for like a little PSP or some shit. Or I would try to browse the internet on my cell phone with those horrible fucking flip phones like way back, but I usually couldn't do anything on it. So I tried to find as much stuff that I could do, like, extracurricular, like hanging out with friends or doing shit like that. Because that shit sucked. Fuck that. G internet? Yeah, I don't know. I don't even know what it was called back then. How do you feel about H Bomber Guy, Sean and Jen, or Folding Ideas? They all seem like cool dudes. Was it called? I don't remember if it was called 2G back then. I don't remember what it was called. Do you have any supernatural or unexplainable stories? If I think real hard, I probably could find some, but I don't believe in any of that shit, so it's just dumb shit that kids see, probably. Have you exhausted all your meme stories? I don't know, dude. Got memes for days. What other memes would we have? I'm trying to think. So much for Destiny's schedule. My schedule is going splendidly. I'm supposed to sleep in 50 minutes. Why am I driving super slow? So that our internet doesn't get cut off. yeah, what am I going to do when I run out of memes? I don't really make a lot of good memes. Or maybe now that I'm single, I can start making good memes again. I'm not sure. Any tips for beginner drivers? I think it's really important to be comfortable with your vehicle. I think that the number one problem that I have with most drivers is it feels like they're not really aware of, like, what their vehicle is capable of doing. And the vehicle is less of an extension of themselves and more like a vehicle that they happen to be operating, that they're not necessarily sure of what it will do at all points in time. I don't know, you should be, like, familiar with, like, the limits of your vehicle. How hard can you push it? How does it respond to, like, different weather conditions? Like, I drive, like, you see me drive crazy all the time now, like, when it's summer and shit. When it's, like, snowing or raining, I drive like a huge pussy. Like, I'm that guy on the right lane of the interstate doing 45, like, on first snow, because I'm not going to be part of the pileup or the fucking ditch mongers when the first snow comes and everybody's driving like a fucking moron. You should also be looking in your mirrors a lot. People don't check their mirrors enough. You should always be looking in your mirrors. There's no reason to stare ahead of yourself all the time. In winter, it's useful to learn gear braking. I'm talking out my ass a little bit, but I disagree. I doubt that's going to help you stop significantly faster than, like, slamming your brakes. I mean... If you don't have traction, you don't have traction. It doesn't matter what mechanism you're using to slow your car down. If your tire can't grip the road, your tire can't grip the road. Does it really matter? I use engine braking all the time just to conserve gas now, but... Do you shoulder check before merging lanes? Yeah, always. I always manually check before merging lanes. I'm always paranoid that somebody's in my blind spot, but nobody should ever be in my blind spot because I'm always checking my mirrors, but I always manually check anyway. Engine braking is for keeping your speed low on hills. Oh, sure, I guess, yeah. I'm always in gear now. I don't think there's any reason to ever be driving in neutral. We can go hang out over here, I guess, until I have to go home and sleep. Didn't you shit on engine braking before? Well, I used to think engine braking was bad because I didn't realize that engine braking could literally make it so you don't use any gas in your fucking engine. That shit is crazy. I didn't know that. But I learned about it. Now I engine brake all the time. Do you think rear view cameras help or just make drivers lazy? I don't know. I've got a rear view camera on my car. I think I find I use it now more than looking because it's really hard to see out the backs of some cars these days, man. The rear view the rear view windows are getting much smaller. What's engine braking? It's just leaving your car in gear and not shifting into neutral. My mom doesn't believe in using parking brakes, even on hills, she just puts it in park. Is this bad? It's a little retarded, but I mean, whatever. I don't know. If it's in park, it should never roll. But I mean, why not put the e-brake on as well? I don't know. Lower gears slow you better, not than your brakes. Why is it that engine braking can be good? Okay, so right now, my engine needs to spin a minimum revolutions per minute to stay on, right? So right now we are rolling forward, okay? Let's go into second gear. Now we're rolling forward. Now, if I put it into third gear right here, I can release the clutch. The car is in gear. I'm not giving it any gas, but the kinetic energy of the car is moving the car forward while the drivetrain is connected to the transmission and the gear is like spinning the motor without the motor having to consume gas, right? This is what engine braking is that right now the energy of my car moving forward is being used to turn the motor without the motor having to actually inject fuel to do it, right? Or based on everything I've read, that's pretty much how engine braking works. Dude, this is the turn radius of the car. I cannot turn any tighter than this. It's actually really annoying. Is this a lie? Oh shit, people can't tell because of what I said earlier. No, it's actually 100% true. So kind of like regenerative braking? Yeah, a little bit. When you put the car in neutral, what happens is when you're in neutral, and you can test this in your car, like right now when I'm in neutral, I'm pretty sure the fuel injectors have to inject fuel to keep the engine turning. It has to. How else is your engine still moving, right? Where are the revolutions per minute coming from if not from your car injecting fuel into the cylinders to cause the cycle to finish, right? But if you're rolling the car and you put it in gear, the spinning of the tires is intrinsically connected now to the engine, right? Because the drivetrain is connected to your motor via the transmission. So now as the car rolls forward, you slow down quicker because the kinetic energy is also being used to turn your motor, right? I'm sorry. I guess it sounds like a lie, but that's what it is. Fuck, I was gonna park here. Oh, I guess we can park in here. Have you ever kept a journal or written a letter to yourself? I started to write a journal when I was in high school because I thought I was the smartest person alive, and I wanted to catalog my thoughts so that when I was older, I could trace back the beginnings of my genius. I'm not even lying. I'm so glad I threw all that shit away. This is why I always say that, like, I'm so glad that social media didn't exist when I was a kid, because, oh my god, I would fucking kill myself. Maybe I would commit suicide, actually. If that had existed on social media, maybe I would commit suicide. I'm not actually sure. Would you ever consider doing spooky urban exploring streams? Probably not. Fuck that shit. Oh, fuck. Aaron just texted me to bring home ice cream, but I just left the gas station, eh? When did you stop thinking you were the smartest person alive? I don't remember. It's been a process. Why not turn off your headlights while parked? There you go. Have you ever been to a strip club? No, but I don't think I would ever go to a strip club. Wait, what the fuck? Now my shit inside got real bright. What's going on with your relationship memes? Nothing. I'm never dating again. That's what I said. That's my goal. That's the dream. Your town seems so eerie. Not really. I don't think so. How did the debate today go? Oh, I can't wait to masturbate over the comments. I thought it was really well. I thought we did good. How would you rate the GTI I might get when it was my first car? I really liked it. What do you see your future sex life looking if you never plan to date again? I mean, you can bang chicks without dating them. When is it going up on YouTube? It's already up. What is something that you've never told us before on stream, no matter how inconsequential? I don't know. I feel like I've told you guys almost everything. No, never mind. No, I haven't. I don't know. There are parts of my life that I don't really share with many people. I don't like to do, like, the pity party shit. And I feel like people look at you differently if you market yourself as, like, being too much of a pity party. I think I've shared, like, most of my life. I think you've got, like, a pretty good, like, overall idea of, like, who I am. I'm more open than most people, I think, with my stuff. I think. The chlamydia stuff is really scary. Yeah, I've never had an STD before. I actually passed up on banging a chick. She said she had chlamydia, but that it was cured 2 weeks ago, and I stopped responding to her. I remember that a while ago, because I didn't want to risk it. She had huge boobers, too. But I was way too paranoid. I don't think I would have been able to get it up, because every time while fucking her... Yeah, I don't know. I didn't like Tinder as much as, like, esports girls. Because, like, the Tinder shit was harder. I don't know. I was really paranoid, dude. And I fucked most of those chicks with condoms, too, which sucked. But I was too... Like, if I was fucking a girl, and she had, like... Because, like, most girls shave, right? If she had, like, a single ingrown hair, I would, like, stare at it, and I would be like, is that herpes? Oh, shit. And then I would, like, mind fuck myself. Like, every time I'd fuck a chick, like, for the next week, I would be, like, in the shower, and I'd be, like, and I'd look down, and I'd feel like, I would have, like, a bump or something, and I'd be like, oh, God, that's it. I'm getting herpes. Oh, my God, I'm fucked. And I would be, like, so fucking paranoid. Oh, my God. Yeah, I don't know. It was really dumb. But, like, with the girls that I would meet at, like, events and stuff, like, we'd normally talk pretty... We would talk extensively before meeting and actually doing anything at an event. So I knew that most of the girls I hooked up with, or all of the girls, we would talk about, like, sexual history, whether we had STDs or not, whether we'd been tested or not. So, like, I was always with girls that were clean. Have you ever gotten beat up? No, never before. Usually most people like me because I make most people laugh. Even people that are like could bully me. I usually was good at making everybody at school laugh. Most people at school thought I was a pretty funny person, I think. Even like I had friends that were wrestlers and stuff that seemed to be cool with me. So how do you broach that subject without it being awkward? Oh, really easy. I just straight up ask a chick. If I start like talking with a chick sexually and she's like not into it or something, then I just drop it and I wouldn't do anything. If a girl's not willing to like openly talk about sex or sexually related things, then she's probably not the kind of person that I want to hook up with. So it's just like whatever. Out of all your relationships, which do you think was the most successful and which do you think you experienced the most growth within? I don't think I really grow from relationships. I think I grow independent of them, even if I'm in them, if that makes sense. When was the last time I got an STD check? I think it was right before I started dating Teresa, I think, is when we both got tested. Will you buy a sex doll? No. No, it wouldn't have been before Teresa. Actually, I think it was right before the girlfriend... it was before the girlfriend after her. It's been a while. Probably like 2 years. Have you ever gotten paranoid about testicular torsion before? Nope. It sounds scary, though. But the worst thing I ever had was my wife. I found this out. I didn't know that this was possible. But when my wife was messing around with me, she did the thing. Oh, my God. This was so scary. I think I've told this story before. Where she was going down on me, and she was, like, playing with my fucking baller dudes. And then, like, she was like, oh, that's really weird. Like, you only have one right now. And I remember she said that, and I was like, wait, what do you mean? And she was like, oh, well, I don't know. Like, one of your dudes, like, went into you. And I freaked the fuck out. Holy shit! I was like, hold on, chill. And I, like, started feeling around, and I only had one fucking ball! And then that's when I learned that, like, if you push on them too hard, I guess it goes, like, back up into you, and I had to, like, ease it out. Oh, my God. That was so fucking scary. For a while, I was, like, so paranoid that shit would happen again. Oh, my God. This shit has never happened to me before. It can happen. Basically, if you press on one of them too tightly, it'll pop back up into your body. It doesn't hurt or anything. It's just really fucking weird to reach down and fucking Armstrong yourself, I guess. Damn. One baller Bonelli, yep. Do you feel prepped for tomorrow? Wait, what happens tomorrow? Wait, what is tomorrow? Oh shit, Fuentes isn't tomorrow, is it? Wait, my Fuentes bait isn't tomorrow, is it? I don't want to go check my schedule. I don't think it is. It's next week. Yeah, okay, that's what I thought. Because it was a while from now, yeah. Do you think it's bad to have sex early in relationships if you really like them? I don't think so. Well, it depends on who you are. No, sexual compatibility is really important. It's a cornerstone of a healthy relationship, I think. So, I don't know. I would say it's pretty important to do it early. Why wait? Like, if the sex is really fucking bad and it ends up being a deal breaker, wouldn't you want to find that out sooner rather than later? What is this guy posting? What the fuck? Why? Okay. What's the coolest shit you've ever saw? I don't know, probably my kid being born? All right, boys, we got 30 minutes left. What do you want to do? Not even, like 20 minutes left. That eclipse was pretty cool. The solar eclipse that I got super cucked at. What would be a reasonable upgrade from this car, from what I have now? I don't know, something like a Corvette? Or something further up, like a GTR? The launch control, all it does is like rev the engine to 5,000 and just keeps it there. Oh, an Audi R8. The R8 looks sick as fuck. Would you want a daughter? Yeah, I think I would have had, I really would have liked to have a daughter. I think that would have been really fun. It would be really interesting to raise a girl. But yeah, I don't think I'm ever gonna have another child. I don't think I'm ever gonna be in a relationship where I can have a kid. What is your favorite sexual position? The prone bone, dude. We already went over that. That shit is fucking baller as fuck. Would you ever consider adopting? Probably not. Why would it be interesting to raise a daughter? What's the difference? I don't know, because I have a son. It'd be cool to raise a daughter. Somebody that's a different gender than me? I don't know. Have you ever tried shower sex? Yeah, but it's kind of a fun meme, but I don't know, I don't really recommend it. The water washes away all the lubrication, and it's oftentimes like kind of cramped and uncomfortable. The water gets cold after a while. There's no easy way to kneel or lay down. It's all really uncomfortable. Eh. Do. It can be like a fun meme to do like every now and then. Or if a chick wants to try anal, you can do it in the shower without making a big mess, which is a nice way to try it. Or if you want to be like really messy, you can do it in the shower and like wash everything away, but what about sex in the car? Yeah, that can be fun. Sure. What's the most illegal thing you've ever done, Destiny? I don't know. I don't really do much illegal shit. I'm a pretty clean person, I guess. Can you show us around your car? Just Google any Focus RS. Hephaestus is the same as every other one, right? What's the weirdest place you've had sex? The most awkward sexual moment of my entire life was when I was in high school. Oh my God. I guess like the weird thing is that like I wasn't much of a risk taker, but my wife was such a risk taker. Oh my God. She was crazy. Some of the shit she did was crazy. So I used to leave my grandma's every morning at 5 a.m. and I would go to I would go to my girlfriend's house. I would sneak upstairs to her room. She would let me in. I would sneak upstairs to her room and we would mess around. Then I would leave at 6:30 because her dad would always wake up. He had an alarm set for 6:45. I would leave at 6:30. I would go to the end of the block and then I would drive my car. I would always park at the end of the block, walk to her house going. I'd walk back out, drive my car back or whatever and do that. I don't remember what happened, but I remember that there was some day where I was going down on her and I was underneath the covers and her fucking mom opened the fucking door, but she never saw me. Holy shit. I was so fucking scared. Because her parents were hardcore religious. I'm pretty sure her dad would have fucking killed me, like got a gun and shot me and I would have fucking died. There was that, and then there was a second morning where, her dad woke up early, and I had to sneak out, like, a fucking back window. Holy shit. And I thought I was gonna die, because we had to get to school, she had to get to school, I was scheduled to be there at, like, 7 o'clock or whatever, and if I didn't show up, her parents would be like, well, why isn't your boyfriend here to pick you up? So I had to find a way to sneak out of the house, out the back fucking window, which was going through her sister's room, while nobody heard me or saw me out a window, and then run down the block, get to my car and drive. Holy shit, that was so stupid. I can't believe we did so much stupid shit like that. Her parents were so religious that, I think I told you this story before. She got a gig singing at our age, at 16, 17 years old, for $15 an hour. She was going to get to sing at a Presbyterian or Lutheran church, and her dad didn't want her to do it because he was like a Baptist or some shit. Those are some crazy things, I guess. What is my biggest fetish? I don't think I really have one. I like everything, dude. I'll do whatever you want to do, my dude. Whatever makes you happy, okay? What is the best memory of pure elation, like the kind where the world around you seems completely different? Probably that new girl euphoria shit. As fucking sad as it is to say. Oof. Can I come join you in Family Fair parking lot on 96th between L and Q? Sure. I'm probably not going to talk to you. That's kind of weird. Why, are you the panda bear guy? Have you nutted from titty fucking? No, never. I don't know if it's possible. Do you think you only care about your partner's pleasure because of your abandonment problems with your parents? I don't think I have any, like, deep-seated stuff like that. My relationship with my parents is pretty good. I like them. They seem like pretty cool people. Or, well, maybe that's stretching it. But, like, I like my parents. I don't have any resentment against them. And I think that most of the things I've been through, I'm a better person because of it, I think. I don't know. I don't feel like I have abandonment issues or anything like that. say a quality for both your parents. My mom is really nice to everybody, and my dad is a ruthless worker. He will work himself to death, which he's doing right now, actually. I think he's supposed to get biopsied for prostate cancer soon because they think that he might have something, and he's still working. Man, they're bad with their fucking finances, but... My dad would work so many hours, and I think I picked that up a little bit. Like, when I got to college, I was working like 60 hours a week at my casino job. I would put in a fuck ton of hours, and when carpet cleaning, I put in a fuck ton of hours, and with streaming, I put in a fuck ton of hours. So, yeah, I don't know. From what you say, it never sounded like your parents were hardcore on your dick about what you did, like a lot of kids with daddy issues. Yeah, my parents just kind of did their own thing, and I did my thing. I never really had much... I probably had, like, attention issues growing up. I've said some of the dumb shit I did when I was a kid to try to get attention from my parents. But I think I grew out of that pretty quickly. Like, by the time I was, like, 11 or 12 or whatever. Should I get a GTI? Yeah, but it's in your price range. I think I had a GTI. I thought that was really good. Why do you think you have death grip if you shoot in 3 minutes just after 2 days? Because I can outlast any fucking chick you put me up against, okay? I will fuck her until she orgasms, and I will be good to fucking go. Guaranteed. No chick has ever bested me in a one-on-one fuck-off, ever. They all say they can do it. They'll all be like, since you're like, oh no, when you fuck me, you'll come so fast. My pussy is the best. Oh yes, you men love me. And I'd be like, bitch, you ain't got shit. Ain't got shit. Have you seen the newer Camaros? Nope. Have you ever had sex with a girl that cannot orgasm from penetration but only clit stimulation? Nope. I've never met a girl like that before, which is really strange because everywhere on the internet, people are always posting like, oh, 90% of women can't come from intercourse. I've never met a girl that can't get off while fucking. I mean, like, sometimes you have to play with their clits to get them off while fucking, but I've never met a girl that can't orgasm through intercourse. I don't know if, like, again, most people just suck, or maybe I'm only with women that tend to orgasm that way because they, you know, they masturbate more or whatever. If the girl has to masturbate, if you want to have good sex with a chick, she has to be a chick that masturbates. Wait, really? My girl can't orgasm through intercourse? Well, good luck, my dude. You can do it. What's the hardest lesson you've learned? Is the probably the dating thing or the new girl thing are the two hardest things that I'm working through right now. What if they lied? You said to yourself, anyone can lie if you don't have enough knowledge of the field. As a guy, you don't have... Could a girl... I mean, like, there are a couple of, like, one-night stands that could have faked it, but the way that I approach sex and the way that I talk to the girls, it would be really weird if they lied about it. I don't know if I believe that, I mean, they could have, but like I said, like, I'm really open with sex-related shit, and I never pressure a girl to orgasm, but, yeah, so I'm not sure. You should be able to tell if they orgasm? I mean, maybe. With some girls, you can. I don't know. Yeah, with some girls, you can. My wife tried to fake one once because she wasn't into it, and I could immediately tell. But she did things when she orgasmed. There were things that she always did, and she didn't do it this time, and it was, like, really obvious. And I was like, dude, like, what are you doing? It was, like, really retarded. I don't even remember what her excuse is. It was really dumb. It was, like, the one time she tried it, though. And then, yeah, she never did that shit again. Pressure a girl to orgasm? What are you doing putting a fucking gun to their head? So a lot of guys pressure women into orgasming, and they think if the girl doesn't orgasm, they failed as the guy. So what it can do is it can build up like a ton of pressure. If you're a girl and you don't normally orgasm from fucking around with a guy, or it's harder for you to orgasm, and then you've got a guy that's like hardcore pressuring you to orgasm, and you know that he's going to feel like shit if you don't orgasm, that mounting pressure can make you even more nervous, and then you won't orgasm, and it just like piles out of control. So, yeah, it's like really, really hard if you're a girl sometimes, if a guy's like really pressuring you to. I'm just curious if the only 20% of women come from penetration alone is true. No, in my experience, it's not. Almost every girl I've been with has been able to orgasm from intercourse. Or maybe every girl. No, there was one girl that I couldn't get off ever. She told me going in that it was really hard for other people to get her off. But and I couldn't get her off at all with using anything, though. But, like, of the girls that I've been with, I could have, too, if I had more than a weekend with her. Because I got close. But rip. But like of most of the girls that I've been with, I think almost all of them can get off via penetration, but maybe those are just the types of girls that that end up getting with me too, though. So it could be like selection bias. I don't know. Where is the clit located? If you just jam your finger inside a chick and then you press up, you just drag it up their body eventually you're going to hit something and they'll jump and then you'll have found it. That's how you do it. No, I'm just don't actually do that. That's the G spot, not the clit. What? No. If you put it, I'm just fucking with you. If you put your finger like on the pussy part, and then you drag up, eventually you'll hit a little nub. It's usually more sensitive than the rest, and then that'll cause them to jump. Right? It was a joke, my dude. You're it's okay. Yeah, actually, I'm talking about the lower part, the entrance to the vaginal canal, and commonly the inner set of lips, known as the labia minora. You want to part that with your index finger and slowly drag them up to... Yeah. Do you think your gaming prowess has made you a superior sexual partner? I think anybody can do good at sex. You just have to be interested in it, and you have to try hard. Like, you have to try to learn stuff. It's a practice skill just like anything else. How long does sex last for you? I think, like, a decent sexual encounter would probably be, like, I don't know, like 10, 15 minutes, maybe? And then if you want to do, like, crazier shit, you can extend it from there. But I think, that, like, anywhere from 10 to 15 minutes is probably, like, a good encounter. What is foreplay? I don't know, oral and stuff? When people say that they fuck for 30 minutes or longer, every single time they fuck, I instantaneously assume one of two things. Either one, this person is a virgin and they're lying, or two, they just don't time how long they have sex for. No girl is going to take a fucking jackhammering for 30 minutes. Like, it doesn't feel good. Like, or at least for the people that I've been involved with, most women in my experience can only handle so much contact before things become too sensitive. Like, if you're fucking a girl for like literally 5 minutes straight, like at some point it's just not going to feel good anymore. Like, it'll start to feel raw inside. If you start including like foreplay and shit, sure. But like, if you're talking about like, if your average encounter is like an hour, what are you doing? Like, 20 minutes a piece of oral? Like, that's a long time, my dude. Like, I 30 minutes, I guess, can be... Sure, 30 minutes is, like, okay, I guess, sure. Can you orgasm from getting head? If the girl is, she has to be really good. When I first started having sex with my girlfriend, we'd go for hours. Like, we'd lose track of time. Suddenly, it's 2 hours later. Well, sure, but you're, like, new to it. And, like, there were times where I was messing around with my ex-wife and shit, and we would spend, like, oh, God. Like, there was a weekend where we went out to her family's lake house. That was a weekend of fucking holy shit. Fuck, that shit was crazy. But like, most of the time, it's like 15 minutes, like, you know. Was any woman good at hand jobs? That's really hard, dude. It's really hard. Because the girl's got to be careful that, like, her fingers don't dig awkwardly into, like, the side of your dick. That's really weird. When a girl tries to grab you and her fingertips are, like, digging into you, if she starts pinching your skin with her nails, she has to, like, squeeze it right. Like, giving yourself a hand job is, like, that's a hard thing, right? You ever meet a girl that's just, like, I don't know. There's, like, a lot of, like, there's very intricate timings with, like, when you're squeezing yourself and, like, going up and down. That's a pretty hard thing to do. But, like, if a girl just, like, grabs you and is, like, moving her hand up and down, or she, like, grabs the base of your dick and is, like, wiggling it back and forth and shit, it's, like, damn, dog. I've been giving myself hand jobs my whole life. You probably shouldn't try to compete with me here, you know? Do you do Kegels? Yeah, so that's, like, actually a really weird thing, because I thought that every guy did that. I think you should be able to, like, flex your dick and shit, and, like, hold shit up with it, right? Like, if I'm, like, ugh, you know, like, kegling my shit, like, I could, like, hoist my headphones and shit off my dick. Hell yeah, dude, that's a shit you gotta fucking train for. But if you're fucking a girl, and you, like, and you do that shit, like, where you, like, ugh, your fucking dick, right, you get him into, like, man mode, yeah, that shit feels real good. That's, like, a really good finisher for me, if you're fucking somebody, is to, like, you know, like, tighten him up, and, like, get him, like, real fucking, like, get him into torpedo mode. I don't know how else to explain it. Yeah, that's some important shit, my dude. Cause girls, when you're inside of a girl, if you know how to do that, like the dick flexing shit, when you're inside of a girl, she can 100% feel the difference. If you're fucking a girl and you start flexing your shit and he's in torpedo mode, she can 100% feel the difference. When you started to do that, that's like a really easy, not easy, but that's like a good finisher meme, I think. What is torpedo mode? I don't know. Like, I don't know how to, like, when you do, like, the Kegel thing, your dick should, like, bounce a little and, like, be like, hey. And, like, if you, like, really, like, ugh, if you really do it, your guy is, like, ugh, like, fucking, I don't know, like, casting rage as a barbarian. It can, like, take twice as much punishment. And it's, like, I don't know how to explain it. I don't know. Maybe we'll chatterbait stream one time. I thought you were talking about the woman. Oh, no. I've never felt the difference when a woman does that. I've been with a couple chicks who are like, hey, can you feel this? And she'll be, like, on top of me, and she'll do that thing where, like, she squeezes her vagina a little bit. She's like, can you feel that? Doesn't that feel real good? I'm like, yeah, it's okay, but can you just, like, go back to fucking me? And she's like, okay. I don't know. I don't feel like that makes much of a difference, but eh. Have you ever had your dick snap the wrong way and then you lose your erection? Sometimes. That's another reason why I get scared of the girl on top shit. I just don't trust girls. I don't trust girls on top. They fly off your fucking dick and then try to come back down on it. Fucking fuck that shit, dude. Even a 90-pound chick will break your shit. I don't know, man. I have trust issues. I don't know. I don't know, man. Girls just weren't meant to be on top of guys. I don't know. Fuck that shit, dude. Have you ever been fucking and the vibrator comes into play and then she's squeezing so hard it's painful? Yeah, usually when girls start to orgasm, they become much tighter. And if it's a really strong orgasm, usually if it gets to that point, usually I stop and you just like stay like fully embedded. Usually when a girl is coming, she likes to have something like inside of her because it feels like you're kind of squeezing around something. So like if you can stay inside, it's a really good feeling for them. But like if a girl is naturally really tight and she starts to orgasm, continuing to fuck her can be really difficult because it gets like really tight and can be really uncomfortable, in my opinion. Maybe it's just because my dick is so fucking huge. I'm just kidding, right? I've been dating a girl for over a year, and I've never once had that raw feeling you're describing after prolonged intercourse. Well, I don't know if the guy feels it. I mean, I never feel it. But I've been with girls where, like, if they don't orgasm, I guess my general experience is that if I'm with a girl and I haven't gotten her off after 30 minutes, she usually starts to get sore. Where, like, I just can't fuck a girl for, like, 10 or 15 minutes straight. Because they start to get sore after a while. Like, oh, like, it's starting to feel a little, like, chafed or some shit. Or, like, I can't do it or whatever. That's been my experience. Maybe there are girls that can fuck for longer, though. I mean, it's possible, sure. Most girls have no idea how to ride on top. They're trying to break my dick. Yeah, so the problem is that girls get off differently from intercourse in some ways than guys do. And when a girl is on top, all she's usually trying to do is grind your, is to grind her clit into your pelvis. That's usually how she's trying to get off. And your dick being inside of her is just kind of like an added bonus, but it's not really that important to the process of her orgasming. And that generally doesn't feel good for a guy because you don't want something that's got your dick and it's moving it back and forth on top of your pelvis. Have you ever used coconut oil? No. Do you ever feel like you're missing out on valuable life experiences due to your career keeping you inside so much? Eh. Destiny seems to dodge words like penis, dick, or balls. Well, I don't know. Dude, like to be creative. Fleshlight versus hand? I've never used a fleshlight. I don't think I would like the cleanup. Fuck that shit. STDs? I've never had an STD before. Thank God. But most of the girls I've been with will get, tested before I get with them. Have you ever eaten the groceries before in a girl? I tried one time with Rachel to do the whipped cream thing, but I actually hate whipped cream, and I realized it afterwards. I covered one of her boobs with whipped cream, and after eating it all off, I was like, this is actually really disgusting. I don't like whipped cream at all. That's why I always get my hot chocolates and no whipped cream. Oh, he means eating ass? Oh, sure, dude. Whatever you gotta fucking do, man. Yeah, hell yeah, dude. Go fucking crazy. You only live once, right? Have you ever had to comprise elements of your personality in order to appeal more broadly? No, I'm actually like, I'm pretty ruthless in terms of consistency. If you can ask any fan that's ever met me in real life. I'm exactly the same in real life as I am on stream. Have you ever had your ass eaten? Like I said, like, my wife was really into, like, anal play on guys. Like, she wanted to try it a lot. But, I don't know, I just don't enjoy it as much, I guess. Or it doesn't do as much for me. Have you ever tasted your ass? We're getting into some meme shit, guys. We're getting into too much meme shit. Are you disgusted by eating someone's ass or vagina? You can't be disgusted if you're gonna give good head. If it's disgusting to you, I don't think you can do it well. No, you gotta get into it, dude. You gotta fucking enjoy it. Live your life, my dude. You only live once. Go big. How would you describe the taste of pussy? I don't know. This is, like, oddly specific questions. Everybody is really different. Every girl tastes very different, I think. Wow, like, really, really different. I've been with some girls who just taste really, really bad, but then there are others who are, like, I could do this all day. It's actually, like, no problem at all. And then some girls, like, taste like nothing. So I don't know. I mean, it's... What does a boob feel like? Boobs are amazing, my dude. If you ever get the chance, just wiggle them around. If I was a girl, I would play with my boobs all the fucking time. What's so great about boobs? I don't know. I just like slapping them together. That's literally all I like to do. If I'm with a girl and she's got big boobs, the first thing we're doing is she's going to lay on her back and I'm going to fucking slap them together. Because that shit is entertaining as fuck to me. And then if I ever come up behind her and she's naked, I'm grabbing the boobs, dude. And we're going to squeeze them. We're going to squeeze them. I don't know. They're just fun to grab. Fuck. I can't. They're boobs, man. Like, what the fuck? Natural versus implants. I've always heard bad things about implants, but I don't think I've ever been with a girl with fake boobs, so I'm not sure. Is there anything important you would say there's to both gaining viewership and keeping viewership in the new mediums of online entertainment? I don't know. Have a gimmick and do it better than anyone else. What's the difference between grabbing boobs and grabbing your knee? They're both skin. Wait, what? What is my gimmick, Ben? I don't know. I'm pretty entertaining, I think. Comedy stuff. Have you ever hummed the ABCs while eating pussy? No, why? People that, like, draw patterns and shit. That's really autistic. I don't know why people do that. Or I don't know. That seems really autistic. I'm not sure. I guess, like, the important thing when giving head is you need, like, the most important thing is to change it up a lot to keep the person guessing. And then when you want to get them off, focus on the one thing that gets them off and then do that until they finish. It's probably like the most important thing. I guess like the ABC shit can help if you're trying to find ways to keep it going, but I don't know. Like your tongue can do a lot more things than just be pointed and like making shapes. Like you can do more than that, you know? What is the Reddit meme for eating a girl out? There's some Nina bullshit video that they link. I don't know. I don't think it's really good. Do you think too much porn or hardcore porn could mess with your sex life? Nah, fuck it, dude. Go hard. Find some crazy shit. Try some crazy shit. I've never tried the grapefruit thing before. I don't know what the fuck that shit is. I mean, like, I've seen the video, but I don't know what it would feel like. For real, how many times have you fucked? At least 4 times. The clit has enough nerve endings for you not to have too much to do, to not have to do too much with your tongue to stimulate it, from my experience at least. So, like, a girl's clit is like a guy's balls in that they're very, very, very different. Like, that's really important. You can't, this is why I say the most important thing you can do is communicate with your partner. You cannot extrapolate your experiences from one girl to another girl. Because this is why you never ask girls for sex advice either. Because when you ask a girl sex advice, she's not telling you what to do to please a girl. She's telling you what she likes. So, like, for instance, right? If you look at something like tongue fucking, there are some girls that go fucking crazy for that, that love the feel of it. And there are other girls that are like, I really don't get into this at all. Like, what are you doing? It feels weird. For things like clits, right? Some girls are like, I need you to literally take this between your teeth and lightly nibble it for me to orgasm. And other girls will be like, you can't even fucking pull the hood back. Like, you can only stimulate this with your tongue through the hood. Otherwise, it's way too sensitive, right? Like, girls have very, 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 very different opinions on what feels good to them. So you have to communicate. You have to communicate to find out what she likes. You can't just assume that every girl likes one thing, you know? If you want, like, okay. If you want, like, here's the one meme. Here's, like, the one consistent meme that I've found that, like, most girls generally like. This is, like, this is the standard finisher, okay? Is 2 fingers in, you push your hand down into the bed, and you put 2 fingers in, And instead of doing the curl motion, you fuck your fingers in so that it's pushing up against the inside of her. And then you combine that with some type of like oral play on her clit. That's like the 99% finisher. I haven't found a single girl that doesn't like that in some capacity. So there's like your, that's your hidden technique finisher or whatever, okay? For when you finally meet a chick. I think that the one thing, this is like a really important variation. A lot of guys do the thing where they put the fingers in and they just curl the fingers. I think that it feels better to the girl if you actually move them in and out while pressing against that G-spot area instead of actually curling them inside. I think it's a better feeling. I think most girls that I've been with feel that way. Oh yeah, and if you're with, okay, or you can use your whole fist or four fingers. If you're with a shirt. Do you care what she likes if it's a one-night stand? Hell yeah. Of course. Having sex is not hard, just don't be retarded. I absolutely disagree with that. I totally disagree with that. I think it's a skill that you must practice. I have been with some unbelievably inept girls. Girls that couldn't suck a dick to save their fucking life. I totally disagree. Having sex is a skill. Have you ever fucked a girl with no rhythm? Have you ever take a girl from behind, and every time you fuck into her, she starts like moving with you, and you're doing this like fucking rocking back and forth motion, and she's like, she's moving her ass back with you as you're trying to pull out. You're like, dude, fucking stay the fuck still or rock correctly, right? Because when you fuck, there are some girls that will try to rock with your body instead of rocking in a counter motion so that it actually makes sense. Like, dude, I don't know. I disagree with that. I think that it's very possible that some people are really, really, really bad at sex. It's a skill. You have to practice it. You have to think about it. You've got to read up and learn on new techniques. And then you have to employ those techniques. And you have to practice them to become proficient at them. That's another reason. Oh, okay, shit. Oh, fuck, dude. I could talk about this shit all night. I need to find a fucking chick. This is another reason why I like the prone bone, okay? If you're fucking a girl while she's laying on her belly and her legs are closed and yours are open and you're entering her from behind, one of the things that you can do is you can put both of your hands on her lower back. So what you do is you press down as you pull out and then you kind of like, then you bend your arms as you push in. So you're constantly moving her body back into you as you fuck her, right? So as soon as you're in all the way, you push down, right, so that you push her body down into the bed, and then you pull out. That's like one guaranteed way to always keep like a consistent rhythm, and the girl can't possibly fuck that up. And it feels really good for both parties, I think. Yo, I do that all the time. Hell yeah, that's like the shit in that position. Okay. All right, are we good? This is our 2017 sex talk. We're good for this for another year. Go out and have fun. Employ all of your techniques. I believe in you guys, my dudes. Be careful. Stay safe. Be careful. Ripperino, cappuccino, pappuccino, cappuccino, mappuccino, mappuccino. I'll see you guys hopefully tomorrow when my internet is fixed. Pray to the Jesus. Pray to the gods. Be careful, my dudes.